Well, good day, farmers. Welcome back. It's been a while since my last my last episode, but whoa, okay, hang on a second. Oh, that was probably a little loud. I'll just turn it down just a little bit. There we go. It was a little loud in my headphones. But anyways, trying out a new recording software after I had a major PC issue, so I had to refresh of everything, a lot of lost of everything, all mods and programs and documents and like pretty much everything except for Windows. Shucks. Well, anyways, but after got a new graphics card and a new power supply, and well, in case you were wondering what I've got now at the moment, I still got the same computer, the AMD A10 7800 series, with a 750 power supply, and the graphics card is the R7 370, 4 GB GDDR5 overclocked, and I've been really impressed of its performance. But right now, since I'm recording, I've noticed that it's dropped quite a bit. I'm usually getting like about more than what it what it is. It's probably taking a little bit more power to do that. Showing 30 frames, clock at 1070. No, I don't know why no VRAM, but oh well. And running a temperature at 65. And just this morning when I turned it on, of course the temperature was nice down and cool. It was at 35, which is the lowest I've ever seen any card that I've, especially the onboard one that was in there before, that is in there now. Excuse me. Well, anyways, enough of that about PC stuff. I am on a map of I'm on the OldStreams map. I thought I'd just giving it a try here, and been playing it for a little while, and so far I've combined 10, 9 and 10 for grass. And just before I started, I bought a few more fields. But there seems to be a little bit of an issue, but it's not it's a nice-ish problem with it, is the price of fields when you sell them. I have the it doesn't show here, but I have the buy and sell fields mod that the field 20, I think it was 23 and 24, but I think it was mostly number 24. The price to sell it was 250,000, but on average these fields are like around 15 to 20,000, so which is kind of a bit of a surprise. So when I sold those fields, it's just like, hello, cha-ching. So when I sold three fields, I think it was. Right now, so far I can join a few of these fields, but not many. I was lucky to be able to do 10 and 9. Excuse me. For anyone that is wondering about a good JCB tractor, this one I have been very impressed with. The JCB 8310 by KABAK, and it's on the the modland.net website. And this this one in particular has 380 horsepower. The climbing power is very impressive. Before for all these problems started on the computer, that when I had the test map, this tractor can go up 90 degrees, which is, I know it's not realistic, but it, but of course when you have full four-wheel drive and full both diff locks and everything, and yeah, it went up that incline like so easy. So after I looked on my YouTube channel, that notice it's been over a week that I usually try and post one up every week if possible. And in a bit I will show you a really good harvester mod that I found, which I find really impressive. It adds a little bit more realism to it. And if you have the well, this map is also soil mod ready, but I've taken that off at the moment. But having that harvester, actually, I could just take a little quick look at it here in a second. It's right here. Combine harvester is used to harvest crops. Blah. Oh yeah, forget to get rid of that, because it's fine. But 1.5 meters. Yeah. But this adds another interesting feature. That it gives a harvest. You have to turn, even though you turn the harvester on, you know, the normal way, then you have to turn on the actually, just one sec. Actually, if you could just quickly show you, close that in. Yeah, there's the options here. Increase RPM thresher. Yeah, you have to turn the thresher in the cab here. On that little panel there, it'll show the RPM of the thrashing part of it. Six. Oh yeah, funny about six. Choose. Yeah, that part I have not been able to figure out just at the moment. But anyways, oh yeah, keypad 8. Just adds that on it. Oh yeah, see on the grain loss, it gives you the option of a grain to adjust the RPM. Activate, deactivate thresher mode 5. It gives you the whole bunch of other really cool, interesting features, which I really like. It just gives that little extra step of realism, I would think. And usually most mods that I usually find are on fs15.lt and modland.net. and also some I do get on FSUK. The Marshall pack I usually get from there. But I've recently up to, oops, got a new Marshall trailer, which is an extended version, which it holds. Used to be 21,700. Now it's about almost, it's around 34 or 35,000 or something like that now. And I've also got the, I also got a new Case Puma tractor, 200 horsepower, with a loader attachment, and also has duals for front and back. Not too crazy about those, but the only thing is, they don't, the duals don't make tracks. Push it back a little bit. And the back to maps again. That and that last major catastrophe on the computer. That all the maps. Well, I couldn't get them still again, just that all the progress was totally lost. I had Ringwoods, Black Rock, had my I started up a Westbridge, but that's gone, and I slowly restarted on that one again, but I've put it on hard. Gonna give that a try. And I've noticed that the prices of things have quite different, quite a price difference for what you get. On here, silage is usually around $3,000 or something like that per liter, as I guess they call it. On the other, at the Westbridge, it's like about 500 or 600. Like, whoa. Whoops, almost overshot that one. And I was showing probably in a bit. I found out what that storage. Well, that's what it is. It's a storage for straw, grass, and hay. But I don't think on this map is really all that necessary, because if you can create bales, then pretty much don't even need it. So after this, gonna pick up the bales and then looks like one and a little bit here. Got enough beacons on the top. That horn is sweet. Uh-oh. Yep. Yeah, drag it along for a little bit. As you can see where the boundary was for that, between 9 and 10. I can get rid of that, but nah, it's alright. Ooh, so close. Just a little tiny bit. Just spit that one out. I noticed there was a little bit down this end here somewhere. Let's see if I can get it. Oh yeah, it was over here actually. I don't know if I'm gonna get 40 liters out of it. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. And then some. Spit that last one out for a little bit there. Now, this baler has a little bit of a... Oops. I just have to get out here a little bit. Yeah, you can't do these, can't raise and lift these up like you usually do. Whoops. Lock them into place. Whoops. There you go. Now I'm just gonna go and park this and then load up the bales. So how many have we got? I didn't really pay attention to how many. Well, that thing is on sale this time. How many bales have we got? We've got 18. Cool. So that those will all fit on one trailer. Yeah, there's the new Marshall trailer right there. Just better watch where I'm going first. Excuse me, one sec. Whoops. Whoops. I just need to move it over a little bit. too much. There. Woo! Okay. Up the pole or something. Yeah, I got the manual attach-detach kind of thing. Oh yes, I got the tractor being serviced over here. Okay, I'm just gonna move right about, put this one right about here because it needs to be, it needs to be washed. Oh yeah, one thing I did was, I had to fix some audio issues with that JCB. Oh, excuse me. Okay, I saw something here. What was that? Mount on off. What the? Oh, that's the, oops, the loader attachment. Oh, okay. Right. This tractor is very handy. Not very powerful, but does the job. And so I've got a front weight system. Not very heavy. Right now it's at 4 tons. I might as well fuel up here. Add disc. As you can see, the front end going down. It's at 1.6 tons at the right now. And boy, I don't have one on the back. Loader, oh yeah, it's by the bales, so that's what I'll have to go and get. Whoops. It was a little tricky to find the right, yeah, it's gonna do that. Yeah, those two bus don't look, they don't like each other too well when you hook them up together. I think I'm gonna take the front weight off, and I'm gonna put the rear one on. Actually, I could probably leave the front one on. It's not ready. Whoa. They get into different areas where, yeah, I see this one doesn't really fit on this too well. As you can see, it's going through the tires, but I can get a vanilla one which will work just as well. Just that the three-point hitch is in so far that it just causes that. But this weight also does the same thing as the front one does. Like, you can add discs to it. So this will make this tractor very heavy. Oops. so close there, I can't, There we go. And also this mod has, this map actually has a dirt feature, terrain and dirt feature. And so you can really make the mud fly on the tires. Let's turn that off again. So we got, what was it, 18, 19 or something like that? So yeah, that shouldn't take too long, I hope. But I'm gonna use one little feature, but maybe. So I'll just go up to about here. And there's three there. Ah, yeah. Okay, this gonna work. Okay. You have to be careful which one you're gonna select, because you got two things hooked up. Oh, pardon me, I just had lunch. Breakfast. Oh, pardon me, sorry. Whew. He's barking up the tree. Nice feature is that you can lock these bales, but there's many other features this bale fork has. You can have it automatic pick them up and just probably just do a few here and we can probably continue on to the next episode. Now these, I did try to fix the issue on these bouncing tires. There's a line in the mod that it's a center of mass, and it has to be all zeros, and if it's not that, if they're not all zeros, then it causes the tires to bounce. Whoops. But I did set them all to zeros, and they're still bouncing a little bit. So, not really too sure what else it could be. Oh, here's another view. I guess you'd call it a bucket cam. Well, that was a miss. Oops. The sound of this tractor is just absolutely amazing. I like it. Whoops. And if in case you're wondering what loader, what mod loader this is. It's the CSZ set, and it's also on the on those websites that I've mentioned earlier. And it's just been updated not that long ago. Whoops. The only issue is with these is that the spikes go all the way through. I guess it's okay if you're doing round bales or anything like that, but square bales, not really. Guess I can go and get those three over there. Is the lock on? Shouldn't be. No, it's not. Okay. Well, look at this here. Two right in, almost in line. Yes, if I didn't have the lock on, you can see they're sliding all over. They're about to slide off. I like how this trailer gets dirty and you can see the footprints. And also that trailer has auto loading and all that stuff in it, and I think it's probably just quicker just to run around and get these. That looks kind of weird. The tractor is dirty, but the weight isn't. Something wrong with that picture. Whoops. On the next episode, I'll probably show you what the map... Well, you did see what the map looks like. It's like this, and of course, I bought quite a few, quite a few fields. Now this is where it's going to get a little bit more interesting because the spikes are all the way through. So just going to go over a little bit because that one is not really not in line. Don't do that. So there's about two more loads, two bale forks. Put too much down pressure on that time. Was going to get that one, but I thought, too much maneuvering. But I thought, this one looks easier. Ooh, look at that, they're just about sliding off. I should probably check this tractor to see why it's the center of mass is probably still not quite set. Oof. But as soon as I put the locking onto these bales, they're not going to be like the way they are when I put them on. There's just this one other feature I'm going to show you here. It's the enable automatic loading. Watch this. Boom. You just drive up to them. Boom. and usually the last one is a little trickier because it's yeah, you pretty much have to be right down and then boom. That's kind of, I find that's a little cheating. Kind of like, I don't think anybody could stack them that like that. And of course, the help menu goes a little nuts. But the thing is, when they're on, as you can see, there's no clipping. Like, you can just go. And the only way to turn them off is like that. And you can't lock them until you back out. Okay, I think that's them all. Oops. Okay, so we'll hook up to the trailer. Lock the bales on. Oops. Whew, got to wait there. Okay, and we will lock the load on. And we press B. Boom. Doing. There we go. And stop unloading. And turn that off. Yeah, make sure you have the loading off, the auto loading off. Otherwise, yeah, see, it's off now. Otherwise, you could be in trouble. I've done it before. Oops. Because I've done it before, is that when I just drove up to here, and then all of a sudden those straw bales right there, they just got onto the trailer. I was like. Oh shucks, not the exact words, but you could probably just imagine what I was saying, thinking of. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna turn this trailer around. Nice thing is when you have that weight on the back, you can turn sharper. You don't have to worry about tire collision zones or stuff like that. Oops, that was a good too. It's gotta be just a. Right there. Well, I think I will gonna be ending this right here for now, and probably into the next episode that will be taking the bales off and putting them into the storage. So, thanks for watching, and catch you all in the next one.